First of all, thank you everyone for showing a lot of love to our previous projects. We love reading your messages and mails. So, in the previous project, what you have seen, we have done simple console-based application, but not this time. This time, we have used many fancy things to make our console look so cool. What makes our console look so cool? We have added some of the graphics and some of the GUI interface. Also, the arrow keys control, like you can control your whole program using the arrow keys and pressing the enter. Like we have not seen in the previous project. In the previous project, what we are doing, we are using switch case, press enter one, and we are doing all that stuff, but not this time. This time, we have named this project as a mini Amazon system. Why we have kept this name as a mini Amazon system? Because the whole functionality of this program is totally based on the Amazon. It's like you can sell a product or you can purchase a product. For selling the product, you have to create your online dukan, and for purchasing the product, you need to search that dukan and place your order. So let me explain you first the admin panel. What the admin panel can do, they have to pass through the login system. After passing through the login system, they can create their online dukan. And while creating their online dukan, they can add a product, they can modify their product anytime, they can delete that product, or many stuff they can do. They can also see the orders which are being placed from the purchase panel of this program. Talking about the purchase panel, in the purchase panel, you will get a list view of all the shops added to the mini Amazon system. After that, you can select that shop. After selecting that shop, you can select the items in this list of the shop and you can place an order. While placing the order, you can select the quantity also, and if quantity is not there, like suppose one person is selling a book and book quantity is 5 and you are placing above 5, the program will display that out of stock. Let me tell you, while creating the file, we have used a dukan name to make a file. You can also see that the whole program is totally based on the C++ programming. We have not used an extra component to create that C++ programming. So let me call the Hemant for the demonstration purpose of the program. So what the Hemant will do, Hemant will demonstrate you the whole program and the flow of the program. But let me tell you one thing, this source code is not going to be free. This source code will be the paid version. You have to pay something. While paying, the coding hall team will totally demonstrate you how to set up this project, because this project setup is very important. This project setup contains many of the additional header files and the source files which you get in the paid version of the program. For the source code, you will get the two numbers. On that two numbers, you can just simply WhatsApp or simply mail on our mail ID codinghall@gmail.com. We will be get in touch with you and we will fully demonstrate you to set up the project. So you might be bored seeing my face. So let's move on to the Hemant side and see the demonstration of the program. I'm also very excited because I also don't know how the Hemant has created this program. I only know the basics idea that yeah, this thing's going to be happen. So let's go to the Hemant person. Thank you.
So here I'm on my computer screen. I have added the supporting and library files which was giving support to the mini Amazon system. Here is conio.c, conio2.h, conio3.h and conio4.h header files are there. So if you will purchase the source code, you will get these header files with the source code also. So you do not need to worry about that. Now I'm running my program. So for example, if you will see Amazon's idea is what? They have two particular website for each thing. For selling, they have separate website, and for purchasing the things, they have separate website. So in mini Amazon system also, I have created two separate panels. One is for selling the items and other is for purchasing the item. And between these, I have created the exit option. And if you will move the arrow keys, if you will move the right and left arrow keys, so this green cursor will be moved and the option will be selected. If you are keeping the green cursor here, the box, you can see that. To register your shop and update item details. And second option is for exit, to exit the program. And third option is to view data for a particular shop and buy items. Third option is for purchasing the items. So I have controlled arrow key using basic functionalities of C++. Suppose I'm a shopkeeper and I want to sell my items on mini Amazon system, and I want to manipulate those items. I want to add the item of my shop on mini Amazon system. So I will press the sell option. In sell option, I have controlled up and down arrow keys using basic functionality. And if you can see that they are reflecting, if I'm pressing the down and up arrow keys, so in yellow box it is showing me everything what the function is for. For example, if I'm on sign up button to register a new shop in my mini Amazon system, in login to login at your shop in mini Amazon system, third option is forget password. If you forget your password and username, so you can press these option. And fourth is for to exit the program. Firstly, we have to sign up any shop. I'm pressing option 1 for signing up. We have to enter a username. So we are creating our shop and name of Coding Halt. Coding Halt I'm creating. And I'm keeping password as coding. In case sensitive language, in small case letter, I'm keeping it coding. This program is totally case sensitive, so you should be very careful about the uppercase and lowercase characters. Here I'm entering shop name. So I'm entering Coding Halt shop. And I have to enter the category. So I will sell coding books on this shop. So I'm pressing Coding shop. This is the category of our Coding Halt shop. Now this is showing us that registered successfully. Now what we have to do, we have to log in our shop and we have to add the items which are present in our shop. So we will go to login. In login system, I have to enter my username, that is Coding Halt, and my password was coding. So login successfully for Coding Halt shop. It is showing the shop name Coding Halt shop. Whenever you press enter, another menu will be pop up on your screen. So here also I controlled up and down arrow keys. Here what can you do? You can add new items, you can view existing item, you can modify items, and you can view orders for your shop, which we will see later on how to view orders for shop, and you can go main menu. Suppose I'm adding an item. In adding an item, you have to enter item code, item name, item price and quantity of item, at what time, how many item you want to add. So I'm entering item code as 101. It depends on your choice what item code you are entering. So I'm entering 101 item code, and item name is I'm selling C programming book. C programming, because coding books is our category. And item price, suppose 456.5. And quantity of item, I'm keeping 30 books here. Do you want to enter more items? Yes, I want to enter more items. So code of the item will be 102, and name of the item I will selling C++. So I'm entering just CPP or C++ I'm doing, and item price is 500 rupees, 500.6 I'm keeping, and enter quantity of item I'm keeping 50 books of C++ programming language. Again I'm entering another book, and code of item will be 103, name of the item will be Java, and price is suppose whatever we can enter, and quantity is 36. I want to add one more. You can add many, how many you want you can add simply. Now again next code is 104, and name of the item will be Python. I'm selling all kinds of book on Coding Halt bookshop. So Python's price will be 560.4 rupees, and quantity of item will be 45 suppose. And now I don't want to add any items, so I am pressing no. Successfully added 4 items. So now we will view items that we have added. So if I will touch on view option, so it is showing me that 101 C programming, 102 C++ programming, 103 Java, and 104 Python. It is showing me the name of the item and price of the item as well as quantity of the item. We have entered 30 C programming books, 50 C++, 36 Java, and 45 Python. Now I'm pressing enter. So we will get again to the back menu. So here I'm trying to modify any item. Here 4 items are there in Coding Halt shop. 101 C programming, 102 C++. So I want to modify any one of them. So I want to modify Java. Suppose I want to modify Java. So I have to enter the item code of Java. Item code of Java is 103. So what can you edit? You can edit name, you can edit item price, and you can add more quantity. Suppose you have 50 books and you wanted to add 50 more. So you can add easily 50 books more. And in fourth option, you can go to main menu. Suppose I'm changing the item price of Java. So now currently 456.45 is Java price, but Java is a technology, not only a language. So I'm increasing it price and I'm keeping it 850.6 rupees. Data is successfully updated. Press any key to continue. Now we will see that our data is updated or not. So I will press on view all items. And you can see that data is successfully updated. Java was previously around 400 rupees, but currently Java is 850 rupees. And we will again press enter. So we will again back to the main menu. From here, we want to go main menu. We will see view order shop option till the end of the video. Now we are back on our main menu and we will go to purchase. As the user, you can purchase anything on Amazon. So we are going for purchase option. In purchase option, whatever option you have here, also I have controlled the up and down arrow keys and I have created a menu that you can view nearby shop, you can view your records, help and exit. So I want to view nearby shop. If you will press first option, you can view the shop by name, by entering name. You have to enter the shop name. But what if you don't know how many shops are there on mini Amazon system? So you have to press option 2. Option 2, you will get the list of the shops which are available at mini Amazon system. I'm pressing option 2. So here are 5 shops. First is Sahuji Ki Dukan, Tiwari & Sons, Sani Construction, Modi Music and Coding Hall shop which we have created now. So what I wanted to open, I want to open Coding Hall shop. So I want to open Coding shop. Coding shop, I'm just entering Coding shop. I have entered the wrong name. So I will again press to main menu. Because there was a category, I entered the category of Coding shop. The name was Coding Hall shop. So I have to enter the Coding Hall shop. That was my mistake, that I entered Coding shop its category. The name is Coding Hall shop. So again, so here it comes with menu and it is showing that what products we have. We have 101 C programming, 102 C++, 103 Java and 104 Python. We have to enter the item code to purchase and we can press 0 to exit. If I will press 0, so it will exit the program and it will print on the screen. Thank you for visiting our shop, Coding Hall shop. Press any key to go to main menu. And from by pressing any key, we will go to main menu. Again, I'm entering option, I'm showing option 1 to you. Option 1, in option 1, I'm showing you Coding Hall shop. I'm entering the shop name and by shop name we will get the list of the items available at shop. There are 4 items which we have entered previously. Now suppose I want to purchase 103 Java book and in Java book I will press, I want to purchase 5 Java books. So if I will enter, so it will ask me details for billing system. It will create billing. So I'm entering my name. My name is Hemant Sahu. And enter mobile number. I am entering my mobile number 9294817724. If you will get any doubt regarding this program or any doubt if you have, you can WhatsApp me on this number. This is my personal WhatsApp number. So anytime you can call me and you can WhatsApp me. Any doubt and any problem related to program. Mail ID suppose xyz@gmail.com I am entering. Delivery address is I'm living near Manit College, NIT, and area pin code suppose I'm entering 35 or something, and district is Bhopal, I'm from Bhopal, and state name is MP. So press any key to view bill. This program has amazing view of bill. I'm just pressing enter and you will just say wow. What a billing system. So you can see that customer name Hemant Sahu, contact number 9294, email, and it is showing us the correct time and date of the program. That date is today's 7th June on which I am creating that video. So it is printing the date and as well as time on which bill was printed, and 103 Java, 5 items I have purchased, and price is 850 multiplied by 5, 4250 rupees I have to pay to Coding Hall shop, and this is my delivery address. Everything is printed on the bill. Now let's press enter, and if we want to view our records, so we can view our records. So it will ask my mobile number. It will show me an order slip. So I am entering my mobile number 9294817724. So there was a previous order 101 Gulab Jamun, which I ordered for Amritesh. If this video will get so many views and likes, so I will surely order Gulab Jamun from that shop. And again, one more order is there of mine from my number. One more order is 103 Java, and unique code also there. Unique code is a special symbol by which we can identify our order. So in this case, unique code is plus, and in this case, unique code is a special character. And my contact number and delivery address, pin code, everything is showing to me. And again, I'm pressing enter. There are two orders from my shop. If I will order anything, so I will get these order in the list also. So I'm pressing enter. And again, I am here on the menu, and I'm pressing option help. In help option, we have created, if a user have any problem, so user can contact us. So these kind of thing we have created in help panel. If order is not placed, so you have to call the CEO of Mini Amazon. If order not received, then you have to call Mohit. And for technical issue, you have to contact me, hemant@miniamazon.com. And for any other issues, you have to call Amritesh, which you have seen in introduction part of the video. So I'm pressing enter, and I'm exiting the program, and we will see that the numbers of items we have purchased. Suppose we have purchased 5 Java books. So 5 Java books will be subtracted from the admin panel. We will see that. Again, I'm exiting that program, and I'm again running that program, and we want to go on sell option. In sell option, I'm logging again Coding Halt, and it was username was Coding Halt and password was Coding, and I'm successfully logged in, and I want to view all items, and you can see that we have entered around 36 books of Java, and currently it is 31. It is subtracted from that, and we will see also the view orders of for shop function, because we have ordered Java book for a shop, and from my name I have entered. So I will we will see the orders for shop. So here is one order which I have created, item code 103, and I purchased Java book, and my name is Hemant Sahu, and my contact number it is showing. So if you will see the any order at your shop, so you can place an order. So it is showing an order on your logging system, and you can see that if we are adding the data from selling panel, so it is reflecting to purchase panel, and if we are manipulating some data to purchase panel, it is showing changes in sell panel, and it is the major point of our program, and it is the plus point also. If you like this feature, then surely you will hit that big fat like button, because it motivates me to make more videos on that kind of topic. And me and my team, we have spent around 15 days and 15 nights, we can say also, on this project, and we have to we tried to bring all the features of Amazon which you will get in Amazon in this mini Amazon system. So we named it as mini Amazon system. So again, I will show you the to open the another shop. Suppose I'm going to purchase option, and I want to visit view nearby shop, and in the list I want to visit Tiwari and Sons. If you will enter the wrong name, it will show the message that the shop name is incorrect. And suppose there are 3 items, Gulab Jamun, Kaju Katli, Barfi, and you want to enter 103, and 103 you want to purchase Barfi, and barfi is not in the stock, if barfi is out of the stock, suppose you want to purchase 400 of barfi is out of stock, sorry, right now you can't purchase it, press any key to continue, because we have entered 400 quantity of barfi and 400 barfi will not be there. So it is showing us the message this barfi is out of stock. So it is the major plus point of our project that it will subtract the number of orders you have purchased from here, and it will reflect the changes in sell panel, admin panel. And if data is out of stock, and it will surely print you the message barfi is out of stock. What if I forget the password of my shop? So whatever I have to do, I just have to go in forget password option. So if you forget your username or password, so you have to click the forget our password option, and there are two choices in the green box: search password by username and search username by password. So I'm choosing first option. I want to search my password using my username, and my username was coding halt, which I have just entered, and I have not forgotten my password, but I'm telling you the option that how can you see the password if you have forget that. So if I will press enter, it will show me that your password is coding. And suppose the data is not there, and if you are inputting the wrong username, I'm pressing option 1 and I'm inputting suppose coding, and it will show me this username is not matched in our database. So this program is have amazing functionality of doing that kind of thing. Now I have done from my side, now back to Amritesh, and Amritesh will tell you how to get the sales source code. And if you surely like the project, then you will surely hit the like button and subscribe the channel Coding Halt, and you can also DM us on Instagram and Facebook Coding Halt, and email codinghalt@gmail.com. So Amritesh will explain you about how to go and get the source code and all the things regarding source code. Thank you.
Thank you, Hemant, for your demonstration. This was a wow demonstration. I was totally surprised that these things can be also happened in the C++ programming. I might think that you have also amazed watching this demonstration. So for the source code, what you have to do, you will get the two numbers. You can just simply message on those two numbers, or you can just simply email us on codinghalt@gmail.com, and the Coding Halt team will be come in contact with you, and they will guide you to how to pay and how to take the project and how to set up your whole project. Thank you. This all was from the team of Coding Halt side. So I think you loved watching this video and you love watching these types of projects. So give us a big fat like button, hit the subscribe button, and motivate us to make a more such project. So we will be back with a new project. Till then, goodbye, have a nice day, and keep learning, keep coding. Bye-bye.